All right, so today we are going to discuss about locators in Selenium. So which is very, very important topic, especially in automation. Okay, so I'll tell you what is exactly locator means and what are the different locators provided in Selenium. And then we will see how we can use the locators to identify the different type of elements. So first of all, let us see what is locator. Okay, and very, very important topic is, so please listen carefully and we'll see. So first of all, what is locator means? So whenever you see some element on the web page, right? So it can be button or drop down or radio button, whatever you can see. So if you want to do some action, we have to do two important things. So throughout automation testing, we have to mainly focus on two things. So one is, let us say we need to first identify this element. Okay. So identification is very important. Once you identify the element, next, we need to perform certain action on the element. So these are the only two things which we have to learn in the automation, guys. Identifying the element, and once you identify the element, then we have to perform certain action. Let us say I have a small text box here. Let's say I want to enter the name here. So before entering the name, so first of all, I need to locate this element. That means I need to identify this element which is present on the web page. And once you located this, then we can perform some action. Say I can just add some value into the element. And here, identification and action. So what is an action here? Passing some value into the input box. So this is called as an action. But before doing that, we need to identify the element. Because there are so many elements we have on the web page. So whichever element we have to perform the action, we have to first identify the element. So to identify the element, we need a locator. Okay, so we need a locator by which we can identify the element. So Selenium will, WebDriver will identify the element by using locator. Okay, so for example, let's say postman. So postman will deliver the letter based on the address which is written on the letter or envelope, right? Similarly, Selenium will identify the element by using the locator which we have past. And what are the different type of locators supported by Selenium? Now we are going to discuss them. Okay, so let me share small presentation. So Selenium support various types of locators. And here, if I just look at a small presentation, we can identify various elements on the web using locators. And locators are basically addresses that identify a web element uniquely within a page. So how we can locate the element? So every element is having their own attributes and properties. Like every person is having certain attributes like name, height, weight, color, right? Similarly, every web element on the web page is having certain attributes. So by using those attributes, we can identify the element. Now, what are the attributes? What are the locators supported in Selenium? So basically, most of the times we have ID and name, link text and partial link text, class name and tag name. So these are the basic locators. Most of the times we use them. ID, name, link text, partial link text, class name and tag name. And these attributes we can directly find in the HTML of the web page. So normally web pages will be designed by using HTML, hypertext markup language. So we can find these attributes directly in the HTML itself, specific to that element. But sometimes if you don't find these kind of attributes, right, then we have to go for customizer locators. So we have CSS selector and XPath. And these two are little advanced level of locators, CSS selector and XPath. And these are not exactly attributes. CSS means cascading style sheet and is a specific language by using the web pages will be designed. And XPath is nothing but a XML path. It is basically derived from the XML. And by using these two concepts, we are going to locate the element. So here we use multiple properties and multiple attributes and different combinations. Like in CSS selector, we have tag and ID combination, tag and class, tag and attribute, tag, class and attribute, different kind of combinations we can use. In XPath, again, we have absolute XPath, relative XPath, and XPath with the different functions. So we can also write dynamic XPath. So there are a lot of things we have. So these are all different locators supported in Selenium. Okay. So first of all, let us start with the basic locators, like how to use ID, name, link text, partial link text, last name, tag name, and then we will discuss about CSS selector as well as XPath. Okay, so first let us start with the basic locators. And most of the times in your web elements, you can find these attributes. And sometimes if you are not finding those attributes, you can just go for customized locators like XPath or CSS selector. Okay. And one more thing, which locator we have to use? So this is a common question everyone will have in their mind. So which locator we have to use? So there is no rule like we have to use only specific locator. So it depends upon your scenario. Suppose some elements having, suppose ID is available, so you can directly use ID. So even though ID is available, sometimes you may not locate element by using ID. Then you can just go for CSS selector and you can use tag and ID combination. Similarly, so name is available, but still sometimes you are not able to locate the element by using name. Then you can just choose some other locator. So these are the different options are available for us, and whichever is convenient or whichever is familiar with you, so you guys can use that particular locator. Okay, so there is no rule like we have to prefer only this particular locator or name or class name, not like this. These locators are different options are available in Selenium. So we have to use any of the locators. But ultimate goal is we should able to locate the element. So that's the main important thing. Okay. So now we will see one by one. So how to use ID, name, link text, partial link text, and then class name and tag name. First, we will let us discuss these things, and then we'll go for CSS selector and XPath. So now let us start with the basic locator. So before using locators, we have to know a very basic about HTML. So HTML is hypertext markup language, and which is basically used for designing the web pages. Okay. So for example, let me just open a web page, and here I'm just opening an application. Okay. So here I have different elements are present in my web page, right? So I want to see the HTML of this particular page. So where I can see the HTML code for this pages, we can say normally right click, and when I say view page source, which will give you the entire HTML code of this particular page. So this is the HTML code which is written for that particular page. But if I see this HTML code, it is very difficult to find out the element. Suppose I want to find this one, free 30-day trial. So this is the button I have. So I want to find this element on this HTML where exactly they have written. So here it is very difficult to find out that element which is present on this HTML. So instead of using this, what you can do is we can just right click on the web page anywhere, and you can say inspect. So almost every browser is having this option called inspect. So when you click on this inspect, which will show you another view like this. So this is a different view which is showing for this page. This is called HTML code. And this is HTML code which is written for this page. And this is a CSS, cascading style sheet, basically which is used for applying the styles on the web page, like colors, alignment, font. So these things are taken care of by the CSS. And HTML will give you the structure of the web page, the skeleton of the web page. And on top of this, if I want to apply any color, we use the CSS language. So these two languages will be shown in two different views. Now, if I want to find out this element on the HTML, simply what you can do is you can just take this arrow, and this is called inspector, and then show the element, whichever element you want to find, click on that element. Then immediately on the HTML, you can see here the particular line will be highlighted here, right? So this particular line which is created for this particular element. And if I just look at this line, you have to understand something here. Every element will having some tag name. Like here, A is a tag name, which is called anchor tag in HTML. href is a one attribute. Class is one attribute. And whatever you can see in the greater than, less than, between, this is called as a inner text. Or we can simply say text. Okay. So this is not attribute actually. This is something, a value. We can say simply value of the anchor tag. So free 30-day trial. This is a text which is displayed on the web page. And similarly, suppose I want to find out something else. Suppose I want to find out this logo and just inspect this element. click on the arrow mark and just click on the logo. Now you can see here, img is a tag name, class is one attribute, alt is another attribute, src is another attribute, and every attribute will associated with some value. Okay, so every attribute is having some value. So every element will start with some tag name. So here, which is an image, so img is my tag name. And suppose, let me just show you some other element. Okay, so let's say contact sales. So let me inspect this element, contact sales. And this is also anchor tag. So because basically, which is associated with the link. So wherever you can see the link, the tag name will be the A. A is representing the anchor tag. Okay. And similarly, let me just open. So learn more. Let me inspect this element. Yeah, this is also having anchor tag. So demo is there. So let me inspect the demo. Oh, this is also having anchor tag. Sometimes you will see the button tag also. Basically, these buttons are associated with the link. So you can see the anchor tag everywhere. And sometimes you can see the button tags, img. Like suppose if it is an input box, you can see input tag here. Okay, and for radio button, check boxes, text boxes, or input boxes, for these elements, you can see input tag. And especially for drop down boxes, you will see select tag. Sometimes if it is a drop down box, you can see select tag. Let me open some other page which contains multiple elements. Okay, so let's see this one. Yeah, so here you can just look at here. Locating this username. So you can see input is my tag name. So wherever you can see the text box or input box, you can see the input is a tag name. And name is a one attribute. Txt username is a value of name attribute. And id is another attribute. Txt username is a value of id attribute. So type is another attribute. Text is a value of type attribute. So every element is having some tag name. It'll start with some tag name. And along with the tag name, you can find multiple attributes and along with some values. Okay, sometimes you may have multiple attributes. Sometimes you may not. You may have only one attribute. Sometimes you may not have any attributes. There are some situations you don't have any attribute. Only you have some tag name. That's it. Okay, so suppose, for example, let me inspect this login. So login, it is also an input. It is also giving like an input is a tag name. Okay. And here you can see some drop down here. So let me inspect this one. And you can see select tag. So for the drop down, you can see select tag and name, ID, and other attributes we have. Okay. So this is how we find the attributes in the HTML. So this is a very basic understanding of HTML. It is very, very simple. And in the HTML is basically a tagged language. If I just try to understand this, this is a whole HTML thing. So HTML is a main root tag and header tag and body tag. In a header tag means all the header part will be included, and inside the body, so there are so many tags we have. So this basically follows some hierarchy. Each tag within having multiple tags like this. Okay. So this is basically called as HTML, hypertext markup language. And we can find all the attributes from this HTML itself. And to see this particular view, what I have to do is just right click on the web page and just say inspect. Or if you don't want to do this, like I simply, you can say F12, function key from your keyboard, F12. When you press F12, then you will get this particular options. So almost every browser like Firefox as well as Edge also having these options. You can find inspect button. And if you press F12 button, you can view the HTML code. Okay, so this is a basic understanding which we need to have before starting locators, guys. So here I have captured something, and here input is my tag name or an element representing an element. Name is an attribute. Txt username is a value. ID is another attribute. Txt username is a value. Type is another attribute. Text is a value. So this is a only three things which we need to understand from HTML, guys. Tag name, attributes, and values. If you are able to recognize this from HTML, that much knowledge is enough from HTML. Okay. So now based on this knowledge, let us try to learn few number of locators. So first let us see ID. So here I have a small search box, and inside the search box, I don't have anything. So here, this is the HTML of this search box, and it contains the two elements, guys. So search input box is different. And here, this is a search element. So these are different. So if I locate this part, this is the HTML I got, right? So from this HTML, if you want to use, if you want to identify this element by using ID locator, so how we can use this? So we can just say ID attribute should be there, right? So I can see ID equal to search underscore query underscore top. So this is a value of ID. So if ID is available for that element directly, always prefer to use ID, because ID attribute is always unique for every element. Sometimes the name attribute also will be the same for multiple elements. In those cases, we don't prefer to use name, but ID is always unique. So if you find ID attribute in the HTML, you can directly use that ID as a locator to find that element. So if I just say ID equal to search underscore query underscore top, right? So how we can use this ID as part of locator? So in Selenium, we have to use this syntax. So the driver object dot find element. So find element is a method which will find the element by using locator. So, but how we can pass the locator by dot? So by is a predefined class. Inside this, we can find all the locators which are supported in Selenium. So by dot ID. So because we are going to use this ID to locate this element, so I say by dot ID, and we need to pass the value of ID here. And till here, this particular statement will find the element. And once it is find the element, then if you want to add some value into it, then we can use send keys of some value we can pass. And this is again action method. So till here, we will identify the element. So by dot ID we have to use. It's very, very simple and straightforward. And similarly, if suppose if you have a name attribute, suppose for the same element, I have a name also. Submit underscore search. So I want to locate this element by using this name. Then what I can do is you can simply say instead of ID, here I have to select name. Again, driver dot find element. So driver is a web driver object. Find element is a method which will find the element by using this particular locator. So by dot name and value of the name, you have to keep in the double quotations. And this will able to locate the element, and click is the action method. And this is basically this one, guys, the search element. And this is a HTML. Button is a tag name, type equal to submit, name equal to submit search, class is there, and other attributes also available. So if the name is available, you can just use name as a locator for the element. Now, link text and partial link text. Link text and partial link text. Suppose here I have multiple links available. So I want to perform the click action on the link. So before performing the click action, first of all, I need to locate the link. So most of the times you don't find IDs or names for the links. Most of the times you don't find names or IDs for the links. So if you just look at this in element, this is a HTML code which is captured for this link. And if I just look at here, A is my anchor tag, class is available, and href hyperlink reference. So when I click on this link, it will go to this particular page. That is href, and the title is there. So here printed chiffon dress. So some inner text will be there. So this is basically link text. So this is called as a link text. Okay, so we don't have ID or we don't have name here, but still we should able to find this element. Then we can perform the click action. So here we have a two options. One is link text and the other one is partial link text. So the first method we have is link text. The other method we also have a partial link text. So we can use either one of them, either link text and partial link text. So we don't prefer to use partial link text most of the times. Always we use link text. I'll tell you why. So driver or find element, again, this will able to find the element by using this locator. So when I say by dot link text, here I want to pass a link text. So we can find the link text in the HTML like this, or we can find the link text which is present on the web page. So you can also directly copy this here. So printed chiffon dress. So this is my link text, and perform the click action. So here till here, which will able to locate the element by using link text. So what is partial link text means? Partial link text means we no need to pass the complete text value. We can just pass a portion of the value. Let's say here I've printed chiffon dress. So I can just parse something like chiff on dress, that's it. You don't need to parse the complete link text. So that is a partial link text. So which will able to locate that particular link by using partial link text. Okay, so what is the difference between link text and partial link text? So this is another important entry question. So in the link text, we have to pass the complete text of the link. When you use partial link text, we don't need to pass the complete text. We can just pass some portion of the link text. And this will able to find the links and then we'll perform the click action. So this is all about link text and partial link text. Now we'll see practically how we can use this locator. So far I have shown you ID, name, link text and partial link text. First we will see practically how we can use this and then we will move forward. Okay, now let's go to Eclipse. And here we already created one Selenium Java project and also we have added all the WebDriver jars. So if you want to create a new project, you can just create a new Java project and add all the Selenium WebDriver jars. And I'm already using existing one. So here I'm just going to create a new package under SRC. Right click on SRC, new package. And I'm just giving as a locators. Is my package name is locators. I say finish. So under this package, so we already added all the Selenium WebDriver jars. So if we just go to properties and Java build path, we can find all the jars have associated with this project. Okay. And you can also find all the Selenium jars under referenced libraries. All right. So this is a locators package, which I have created under my Selenium WebDriver project. And now I'm going to create a new class. Okay. So I will name it as locators. Demo one. Let's take a main method and say finish. All right, so now I created a new class locators demo which contains a main method. So here what I'm going to do is let us try to use this application. So this is a demo application which you have and we can try all the locators in this application. Let me open the application here. Everybody can access this application. So you can try this URL. So this is small application I have. So in this, let us try to use a different kind of locators. So first of all, this is the element which I have shown you on the presentation. And here search element and this is a search button. Okay. So suppose here I say t-shirts. I'm searching for something called t-shirts and then press enter or press this search button. And then it will show you t-shirts which are available in this particular portal. So all the t-shirt links are available here. And here these are the different links, top sellers. So this is one link, second, third, fourth, different links. If I just click on the particular link, which will give you the details of that particular product like this. Okay. Now what we are going to do is let us try to locate the element by using ID, name, link text and partial link text. First, let us start with this element. Okay. So for that, what you have to do first? So first we need to launch my Chrome browser. So for that, I need to first system.set property. Okay, and here we have to pass two arguments. The first argument will be the browser. I say key value. So webdriver.chrome.driver. So this is the first key parameter. And the second argument will be the location of my Chrome driver. So which I already downloaded earlier. So let me just go to location under my drivers, Chrome driver, and here my Chrome driver is available. So let me just copy this driver and provide the location along with the name of the driver. Okay, now I'm copying this and put it here and then semicolon. Okay, so this is set the Chrome driver path and then we have to create web driver object which will launch our browser. So I'll say web driver driver equal to new Chrome driver. So because I want to launch my Chrome browser, so I'll say Chrome driver and then import this web driver from org openqa.selenium and import this Chrome driver from org openqa.selenium.chrome. So this particular statement will launch our browser. And once it is launch our browser, then I need to open the URL. So how to open the URL of application? We say driver.get, driver.get. So get is a method by which we can launch a URL on the browser. So let's copy this URL and then I'll put it in the double quotations. So this will launch our application on the browser. So as soon as it launch application on my browser, so what I'm going to do is, okay, so most of the times, guys, when you launch your browser, your application will open like this in small window like this. Okay, sometimes it display in the small window, we cannot see all the elements. So sometimes some elements are not visible. So what we can do is we can just maximize the page like this so that we can see all the elements. So how to maximize this page by using Selenium WebDriver is we have a command called driver.manage.window.maximize. So this particular command is always preferable to use so that we can see all the elements on the web page. All the elements are visible, or else your window will be very smaller. And this is not a mandatory statement. This is optional. If you want to maximize the page, you can use it. So this is for maximize web page. Okay, not mandatory thing. Okay, so now, so let us try to locate the element. So here I want to locate the, let me open the page again. This is a application page. Right, so now I want to locate this element by using ID. Okay, now inspect this element and then inspect. Right click, directly can also use inspect here. Right click, inspect, and then you can see the HTML of the particular element. So if I just look at here, you can find ID element. So ID attributes available, ID equal to search query top, right? So just double click on this and it will automatically select it, then copy control C and then go back and then write a statement. So driver dot find element. So this is a method we always use to find the element. And here we have to pass a locator. So how to pass a locator? By dot, so this time I'm going to use ID. So we can use ID as a locator. So it will automatically populate here. You can just look at here in the class name, CSS selector, ID, link text, name, partial link text, tag name. So these are the different locators supported by Selenium. So here I'm selecting ID and then in the double quotation, I can just say pass ID. So till here, this will able to locate the element. Okay. And then followed by action. So I'll say send keys method, which will pass some data into the element. I'll say here, I'm searching for t-shirts. That's it. Okay, so driver.find element, and we pass the locator and followed by send keys. And suppose sometimes we should perform some multiple actions on this element. Suppose if there is any requirement to perform multiple actions on this. So instead of writing this statement multiple times, what I can do is we can store that element in a variable. So driver.find element by dot ID, this one we pass the ID value, right? So what this will do is basically this will return a web element. It will return that element. So the returned element we can store in a variable. Let's say I create one variable here, search box. Okay. Now what kind of element it should be? So this statement is returning something for us. So this is located the element. It is find the element. Once it is found the element, this will return that element into this variable. So once the element is returned into this variable, we can define this variable as web element type. Okay. So web element, remember this, this web element also we have to import from org.opencure.selenium. Now this variable is representing the element, and then take this variable and dot here. You can use send keys method and you can pass a value like this. Okay. You can write two statements like this. So we can directly use this method along with this statement driver.find element locator dot send keys, or you can store that element in a variable. And that element variable dot send keys method you can use. Okay, so either way you can use. So this is a way we can locate the element by using ID. right? And similarly, I'll also try to locate another element, this one, by using name element. So if I just look at this, I'm highlighting the second element, this one, okay? And you can see button element. Button is an attribute, and type is available. So button is a tag name, type is an attribute, name is another attribute, class. And if I just look at here, we don't see ID attribute here, but we have a name attribute called submit underscore search, right? So we can use this name attribute to locate the element. So this particular one I'm able to locate now, so that I want to perform the click action on that. So let us try to use this name. So one more statement I'm writing. So driver dot find element by dot, this time you have to use name, just a name, not a class name, okay? So name is a different, class name is a different. So take the name attribute, and here we have to pass the name. And if you want to perform the action, dot click. So click is an action here. So this is a how we can locate the element by using name. Okay, so this is additional statement I have written, and here within single statement I have located the element and also perform the action. So ID and name locators we have used in the two statements. Here we use ID and here we use name. Now let us try to execute and see how it is going to locate the elements. So run as Java application. So now I have run my script. It is launched in my browser. And then opens a URL of application. Then it will automatically maximize the page because we have written the message or statement. And now you can see in the search box, you can find something called t-shirts, which we have entered. And also it is click on this search button. So it is giving the products here. Okay, t-shirt products is displayed on the web page. So that means we are able to successfully locate the search box by using ID, and we are successfully click on this search button on by using name. So these are the two locators we have used. So it is very simple and straightforward, guys. If you find ID or name for the element, you can directly use them. And next one, we'll see link text and partial link text. So on the same page, if I just look at here, let me just close this window. So here I have already passed t-shirts, and then say click on search button. Then after that, it will show you some links here. You can see top sellers. So these are all the different links which are displayed on the web page, right? So I want to click on the first link here. I want to click on the first link. So let us try to locate, inspect this element. And directly you can right click on the element, inspect. And now we can see the HTML of the particular element. And if I just look at here, so anchor tag which is displayed, so A is representing a link, and a class is available, and href is also available, but I don't have any name or ID here. So what I can do is I can use this link text, printed chiffon dress. So this is called as a inner text or a link text. So which we can use as a locator. So this is a link text, okay? Now how we can use this? And by using this, first of all, we need to locate the element, find the element, then we'll perform the click action. So now go back to the Eclipse, and here, let's continue this. Link text. So how to use a link text? So use a link text means we can say driver dot, driver object dot find element. Here by dot, you can find something called link text and partial link text. So both are available. So let's take a link text first. So when I take a link text, we have to pass the complete value of the link text in the double quotations. And if I just go to the HTML, just double click, it will select the link text, copy, control C, and then pass it here. And this will able to find the link by using link text. And then what is an action I want to perform? I want to perform the click action, dot click. So we can locate the element, or we can locate the link by using link text. So most of the times we don't see IDs or names. In those cases, we can use link text. and this will able to find the link and perform the click action. And instead of passing the complete link text, we can also pass some partial link text. So we can use another method. Instead using link text, I can also use driver dot find element by dot partial link text. So in the partial link text, we no need to pass the complete value, and we can just pass some portion of the value. So let us say I want just pass this one, and that will able to locate the element. And one more important thing is these values are case sensitive. So whatever values we are passing inside this locator, they are case sensitive. We have to pass exactly the same way, whichever is there in HTML. Okay. So by dot partial link text, and this will able to locate the element followed by click. And one more thing is find element is a method which will return the web element. So here we have stored this element in a variable, right? Similarly, you can also store these links in a variable. So that variable type always should be web element, because everything is a web element on the web page, even text box, link, radio button, drop down, whatever you can see on the web page, which is a web element. So find element is a method which will return a web element, so that we can create one more variable and store as a web element. So you can also try this for links, but here I don't need to perform any other actions on this, so that I can directly use action method. So either you can use link text to locate the link, or you can use partial link text. And what is the difference between these two? Link text, if I want to use, I have to pass the complete value of the link text. When I use partial link text, I can just pass some portion of the link text. Okay, so first let us try the first one. So first it will launch my page, then it will pass some value into the search box, then it will enter, then it will click on the submit button, then it will click on the link. So this will perform the click action here. So once you click on this link, one second. So once you click search for it, then we got some links here, right? So once you click on the first link, which will give you the detailed information about the product. So this is the flow. Now let us run our script. Right click, run as Java application. Okay, now it is launched in my browser, opening URL. Maximize the page. Then it is pass a value, click on the search button. It is listed out all the products. Now I click on the first link. Now we can see the product page we can see here. So this time we have used link text, right? So let us try to use partial link text. Let me comment this. I'm opening this link text and partial link text. So both I have used. So let's try to use partial link text this time. So right click, run as Java application. Okay, now it is entered the value, click on the submit button, then click on the link, then we'll get the product page. Okay, so this is how we can find the elements by using link text and partial link text. So this is the usage of link text and partial link text. Okay, so far we have discussed about ID, name, link text and partial link text. Then we also have class and tag name. So by using this class and tag name also, we can locate the elements. But most of the times we use class or tag name to find multiple elements, because so tag name and class is not a unique. Suppose when I see this particular web page, okay, and if I just go to the home page, and if I want to find, let's say inspect the page, and if I see here tag name, what is the tag name means? So every element will start with the tag name. Suppose let me just locate this element. And input is there. So the input tag name is there for multiple elements. There are so many elements we have in this page, web page. All the elements are having, most of the elements are having input tag. Okay. And if I use a tag name as a locator, which will match with multiple elements. Okay. And similarly, if I just want to use CSS, and that is a class. So sometimes this class value also may be same for multiple elements. Not every time, but sometimes. Okay, most of the times. So class and tag name. So these two locators, most of the times we use to find more than one element. To find more than one element. Suppose there is a requirement like I want to find out, let's say in this page, I have multiple sliders are there. So this one slide, second slide, third slide. So there are multiple slides are going on. So I want to find out how many slides are there here. And then I need to find more than one element. And similarly, I want to find multiple links present on this web page. How many links are there in the web page? Then I want to find out all the links which are present on the web page. So in these scenarios, especially, we use these two locators. We can also use for single element. We can also use this locator to find single element, but the class name and tag names will be there for multiple elements most of the times. Okay. Now I'll show you how we can use this class and tag name locators on the web page. So here again, my requirement here is, so I want to find out how many sliders we have on this web page. So if I just leave the page as it is, the sliders will go on like this. I think almost 4 to 5 sliders are there. So you can see all automatically the sliders will scroll on one after another, right? So I want to find out how many sliders are there in this web page. So what we have to do is, first of all, we need to find all the sliders, okay? And then we have to count them. Okay, we have to count them. So first look, let us inspect this element and we'll see what are the exact attributes are available for these sliders. And just right click on inspect on one slider, and something you can see here, or else you can just take this arrow mark and highlight this slider like this. Okay, and these are basically images, so you can find img tag. You can see as soon as I put my cursor on the img, it is also showing the image file here, right? So, and if I just go a little bit up, there is a li tag and there is one more li here. So this is a one more image, I guess. So this is one more image. So if I just look at this HTML, so this is one image and this is the second ing tag. And if you just little go up, and there is one more li tag, and here also one more image is there. So this is one more image, right? So if I just look at this HTML hierarchy, in li tags, the images are present, and UL is nothing but a user list. And inside this list item, so li is representing list item. So inside the ul tag, there are multiple li's, li1, li, this is one li, second, third, four, and five li's are there. So that means there are four images we have. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 li's are there. So totally 5 images are there. So li is just a list item. It is not representing the image. So if I just go inside the li, there is an anchor tag, and inside the anchor tag, there is an img tag. See this, li contains a tag, anchor tag, which contains img tag. And same hierarchy for the second element, second li. Expand the li, anchor tag, inside the img tag. And here exact image is available. And again, third li, if I expand, inside this we have an anchor tag, and inside this we have an image. So here we can find the image. Similarly, third li tag, so anchor tag, inside this we have an image tag. And similarly, the last li, which contains the anchor tag, which contains the image tag. So this is the hierarchy which is followed in HTML. So now what I have to do is, I want to find out how many sliders are there, how many images are scrolling in the slider. So if I exactly count these li items, if I just look at here, so li is there. So here it is one more li, and here one more li, one more and one more. So totally 5 li tags are there, list items. So if I find how many are there, how many li tags are there here, that is exactly equal to how many sliders, how many images are scrolling, right? So what I have to do is, I need to get all these li elements, list items. I need to get all the list items. So how to get all the list items? So we need to find out some common attribute which is available for all the list items. So what is the common attribute we have for li tag here? The class is available. For another li tag, another class is available. So class attribute is available for every li, and the value of the class is also exactly the same. If I just look at here, home slider hyphen container, and the second class home slider hyphen container, home slider hyphen container. So in every place, class value is exactly the same. So if you want to find out all these elements, we need to have a common attribute by which we can find all the elements. So here class is an attribute which is common for all the list items, so which are representing the slider. So now I want to capture all these elements by using this class attribute. Okay, now we'll see how we can do that. So let me just create another example. And I'll create one more class, say locators demo 2. Locators demo 2, I'll take main method and then finish. Okay, so I'm just copying the same code, whatever we have created till here, because I'm using the same web page. All right, so now, so we have created system.set property. We created web driver object, which is launcher or browser, and open the URL and maximize the page. Now, so here my requirement is I want to find out how many sliders we have. So these are the tags I have identified on the HTML, which are representing the sliders. Li first, second li, third, fourth, and fifth li's. Okay. And each li tag is having some class attribute, which is common for all the elements. So now what I'm going to do here is listen carefully. Here, go to Eclipse, and here I'm going to write one method called driver dot find elements. This is another method, guys. Find element is a method by which we can locate only single web element. Single web element. When I use find elements, we can find more than one element. So find elements is a method by which we can find more than one element. So that is the difference between find element and find elements. This is another important entry question. So driver.find element is a method which will return only single web element, whereas find elements is a method which will return multiple web elements. But we have to write a locator which will match with multiple elements. So here, if I just look at this class, is same for multiple elements. So here I'm writing like this, by dot class name, by dot class name. So what is the class name we have noticed in HTML, which is common for every element? Home slider hyphen container. Home slider hyphen container. So this is a same everywhere. So I'm just capturing that class value and putting the double quotations and then semicolon. I'm not performing any action here. So just I have located multiple web elements. So if I just look at this locator, which will match more than one element, because the class name home slider container will be there for multiple elements, that is multiple sliders. So here this locator is matching with multiple elements, and here find elements will method which will return multiple web elements. If this return multiple web elements followed by, I'm using one method called size. Okay, now this particular statement will identify more than one element, and size method will find out how many are the element, how many elements are identified. And basically it will count number of elements which are written by this particular statement. All right, so driver dot find elements, by dot class name, and here we pass the class name which is common for multiple web elements, and this will return multiple web elements followed by size. So size method will find the size. Size means how many elements are written by this statement. Okay, so now let us store that number in a variable. So I'm just giving some number. I'll say slider number. I'm storing that value in a variable. Okay, slider, or I'll say number of sliders. I say sliders. So this particular statement will find multiple elements followed by size method. And here we use class name as a locator. Now we can just print this value. I can say system dot out dot println. I'll say sliders value, I'm printing. So So now what we will get as an output here is this statement will find multiple web elements by using class name, and size method will find out how many elements this statement is written and store the final value in the variable, and just I'm printing here. Now let us try to execute and it will show you exactly how many sliders are there in the web page. Okay, so now it is launched my page. Okay, so it is just count them and just it will give you the number. Yeah, now you can see exactly 5 is written. So that means this particular statement will be able to identify the elements by using class name, then find the size, how many are there. Okay, so this is the exact scenario where we can use a class name. So most of the times class name will be the same for multiple elements. Okay, and similarly, we also have something called tag name. Okay, here I will show you, this is a how to use class name as a locator. And now I'll show you how to use tag name as a locator. Tag name. So sometimes even tag name is also same for multiple elements. Okay, so in those cases, how we can use a tag name. So here again, my requirement is I want to find total how many links are present in this web page. I want to find how many links. So this is a one link, second, third, okay. And there are so many links are there. So these are all different links are available. So I want to find out how many links are present in this particular web page. Okay. So then what I can do is when I suppose, let me just inspect this element, contact us, inspect. And if I just look at this element, A is my anchor tag. So this is my tag name. So find every time. So whenever you see the link on the web page, the link is always associated with the anchor tag. So always, whenever you see the A means that is a link on your web page. Okay. So you can find n number of anchor tags on the web page. So all anchor tags are representing the links which are present on your web page. So here my requirement is I want to find out all the links. I need to find all the links which are present on the web page. So then we have to find out the common attribute for all the links. So what are the common attribute we have? So if I just look at the attributes, href will be different, titles will be different. Sometimes we have link text that is also different. So we cannot locate multiple links by using those attributes. So in those cases, we can just go with a tag name. So here anchor tag, which is common for all the links. So here what I'm going to do is observe this. I'm saying driver dot, here also I'm using find elements, because I want to find out multiple links. And what's the locator I'm using here? By dot tag name I'm using. So tag name. And what's the tag name here? A is my tag name. So driver dot find elements by dot tag name. So this particular locator is matching more than one element because there are so many links are on the page. So every link is associated with the tag name called A. So outside we use find elements. So this locator is matching with multiple web elements. Find elements also method which is returning multiple web elements. So overall this particular statement will return multiple web elements. So what are those web elements? All are links. So now I'm going to use size method here. So that will give you the number. So how many links are present on the web page. So I can store that number in a variable. So int links. And then I can print that value of links. I say system.out.println. I can just print links here. So this is how we can use a tag name. So tag name A, which is matching with multiple web elements. So here I'm using find elements so that it will return. The size will calculate how many elements which is written by this statement, then store that value in a link variable. And then here I'm printing. So let me just run as Java application. So now we will see how many links will be there on the web page. Okay, so now it is launched my application, maximized. So first of all, it will count all the sliders and then it will find out all the links. I'm just closing my page and then go to the, see now here 5 is the number of sliders, totally 149 links are present in the web page. So totally 149. So this particular statement will able to locate multiple links by using tag name. Then size is a method which will find how many elements it is returned. Okay, so this is how we can use class name and tag name as a locators to find the elements. All right, so far we have seen how to use ID, name, link text, partial link text, class and tag name. So these are common locators which we are going to use very frequently. So apart from this, we also have something called CSS selector and XPath. And by using these locators, we can find the elements in a very efficient way. So sometimes when you use these common locators, you may not be able to locate the elements. The web pages are very complex and there are so many types of elements, then sometimes you may not be able to locate the elements by using these locators, common locators. In those cases, we can just go with CSS selector or XPath. So these are the advanced level of locators we have. So now we will see how we can use CSS locator, CSS selectors. And here there are multiple combinations we have with tag and ID combination, tag and class, tag with attribute, tag, class and attribute. So there are different combinations we have to use to locate the element by using CSS selector locator. Okay. So now I'll show you how we can work with the CSS selector. CSS selector. So here we have multiple combinations. So let me write all the combinations. Just a second. Okay, so now let me put it here. These are the combinations, guys. So tag name is always optional, but we can directly use ID, class, attribute or something. So this is basically CSS selector combinations. So let me just show you how we can locate the elements by using CSS selector. CSS means cascading style sheets. And this is a basically another language which by which the web pages will be designed. All right. So now let us see how we can use the CSS selector. So for that, I'm just going to use another web page. Let us go with another web page called facebook.com. Okay, so let me just use the locators in this particular form. So we have email address field and password field and a login button and create a new account. Okay, so here how we can use CSS selector for these elements. So let me open the presentation. So these are the different combinations of CSS selector, guys. So tag and ID, or we can use only ID like this. Hash is a symbol, dot, class or attribute. So I'll show you these combinations. First, let us see about tag and ID combination. So tag and ID combination. So here I want to locate the first element here on this page, on this form. The first element is a name field. Okay. And if I just look at the HTML of this field, this is a HTML. Input is my tag name and there are so many attributes are available. Type, class, name, ID, data tested ID and placeholder, autofocus. There are multiple attributes and also values are associated with this element. Now I want to use CSS selector to locate this element. In the CSS selector, we can use a different combination. So this is a method which we have to use in Selenium. Driver.findElement by .CSS selector. For all the combinations, whatever we have shown here, for all the combinations, we use single method, that is CSS selector. But the value which we are passing here is little different. The syntactically it is a different. But for all the CSS selectors, which we have to use here is a common method, CSS selector. Okay, now let us see how we can use tag and ID combination. So if I just inspect the first element, this is the HTML which you have got. And the statement will be like this, driver.findElement by.css selector of, if I want to locate this element by using CSS selector, the first combination tag and ID you can use like this. Input is my tag name, the element tag is input, and the value of ID. So ID is available, so the value of ID is email. So you can pass email. So tag and ID will be divided by using hash here. So tag and ID combination. So tag and ID, so first we say tag, hash, and then value of ID. So this is the combination guys. So hash symbol we have to use to separate tag and ID. So CSS selector, tag name is input, hash, the value is email. So we don't need to pass like ID. So just the value of ID we have to pass. So this is a combination, tag and ID combination. And this will able to locate the element and followed by send keys method you can use. And the tag name is always optional. So tag name is not mandatorily required. You can directly specify hash, the value of ID. Okay, so hash, ID is always representing with the hash. In the CSS, ID is always representing with the hash symbol. So here, no need to pass the tag name. So tag is a optional value. So you can use either this way or you can use this way. So both will identify the element by using tag and ID combination. So this is tag and with ID. Similarly, we also have tag and class combination, tag and class. So for the same element, tag is input and class is input text. So class is input text. So after the spaces, whatever we have, we should not consider that as a value. So input text is a value of class. So how we can use tag and class? You can use like this. Tag is input, class is input text. So both should be separated with the dot symbol. Remember guys. So tag and class is always separated with the dot. Tag dot, tag name dot class. So whenever you want to use this combination, you have to use a dot. And whenever you see class, dot representing the class. So in the previous slide, hash is representing the ID. Similarly, dot representing the class. So without using tag name also, you can directly use like this. So by dot CSS selector dot input text. So this is a direct class, you can use it here. But you should not use class name here. So class name is a different locator. But here we are using CSS selector as a locator. And CSS selector can accept multiple combinations. So tag and ID, tag and class, tag and attribute. So different combinations. So here tag is optional, not mandatory, so that I can directly specify dot class. And here tag name dot class. Either you can go with this one or this one. So this is tag and class combination. So first one is a tag and ID. So tag name hash ID. And the second one is tag and class. Then tag and attribute. So what is tag and attribute means? Here attribute means we can use any of the attribute. Okay, any attribute we can use. Either class we can use or name we can use, ID, data tested ID, placeholder, any attribute we can use along with the tag. So how we can use? You can write either this way or you can write in this way. So if I just look at this bottom one, by dot CSS selector, here input is my tag name. Input is my tag name. And attribute means which attribute we have to clearly specify that. So here I'm taking name as an attribute. So name equal to email. So the value also we have to put. And here we no need to use single quotations or double quotations. Directly name is a attribute, email is a value. So both combinedly we can call as an attribute. So input is my tag name and whatever we put in the bracket that is called as a attribute, name equal to email. So instead of this, you can also use something called class also, or class equal to input text you can use here, or you can use placeholder, placeholder equal to email address or phone number you can use, or you can use data test ID, royal email also you can use, because attribute in the sense it is a generic term. So generic means you can use any attribute you can use within the square brackets. But in case of previous things like tag and class means we are specially saying class. So we have to put only class here. We cannot put any other attribute. Similarly, in the tag and ID combination also, we have to put only tag and ID. The value of ID is email. So we cannot put any other attribute. But here, tag and attribute in the sense, this is a more flexible. So tag is input,
attribute means we can use any of the attribute of this element. I'll say name equal to email I have used. So this is tag and attribute combination, tag and attribute combination. Similarly, we also have another combination, but tag, class and attribute. Sometimes you may see tag and class are exactly the same for multiple elements. Sometimes you will see tag and class is the same for multiple elements. To differentiate those two elements, you can use another, we can add one more attribute. So how we can do that? If I just look at these two elements, email address and password. So what is the tag name of these two elements? Input is a tag name. So it is same for both elements. And what is the class of the elements? So class here, input text, here also input text. So even class is also same for both the elements. So tag and class combination, if I take, which is matching with two elements, but I want to differentiate these two elements. I want to uniquely identify the element. Then you can define additional attribute. So that will differentiate the elements. So tag and class values are same for both elements. So to differentiate them, I will add one more special attribute, and that attribute will be differentiate these two elements. So what is an attribute we can use here? I can use data test ID. You can see data test ID royal email here, data test ID royal underscore password. Okay. So this attribute I can use. So how we can write the statement? Driver.find element by .css selector. Observe this. Tag and class. So tag and class means separated with the dot. Input is a tag name, input text is a class. And how we can put the attribute in the square brackets? Whenever you want to put attribute, always keep inside the square brackets. So data tested ID equal to royal email. So this particular statement will identify the first element, and you can pass the value by using send keys. Similarly, the second element, tag and class. So tag is input, class is input text. The attribute is data tested ID equal to royal pass. And this attribute will differentiate the elements. And this will identify the second element and pass a password by using send keys method. So this is how we can use tag, class and attribute combination. Okay. So tag and ID, and tag name is optional here. Directly we can specify ID by using hash. Tag and class, here also tag is optional. We can directly specify dot class. Tag and attribute, here tagging is also optional. We can directly specify the attribute value in the square bracket. And tag, class, attribute combination we can use. So these are the different combinations we can use in CSS selector. So now let us see practically how we can use them. So let us go to Eclipse, and then I'll create another example. Let's create locators demo 3. Let's take a main method and then finish. Okay, so this time I'm going to use a different web page. So for that, first we have to specify system.set property, driver and URL of your application. I'll copy these two statements, three statements. Okay, so now I specify system.set property, setting the driver location and driver object creation, and we need to change the application web page. So I'm copying this URL and then put it here. So this is my application URL. All right. And then this will maximize the page. And after maximizing the page, now observe this. I'm going to locate this first element, email address, by using tag and ID combination. So tag and ID combination. So when I try to inspect this element, tag and ID, right? So how we can do this here? So this is input. Okay, so this input is my tag, and the ID is email is my ID. So tag and ID, input ID value is email. So how we can use this? Driver.find element. So here we are able to locate one element. So we are trying to locate one element. So it's a find element. So by dot, so here this is a method we have to use, guys. CSS selector. And simply you can say ID. If you want to use ID as part of CSS selector, I say hash email. Directly you can use like this. Hash email, and put that into double quotation like this.
okay, and then followed by send keys. And here I'll say some name like this, send keys. So CSS select directly you can pass ID here, hash email. Okay, so if you want to test this whether hash email is working properly or not, you can just say in the HTML, you can just find control F, it will open the search box here. You can just check it here whether your selector is correct or not. So when I say hash email, just observe this, what happens? So it is able to highlight that line. When I press enter, it is trying to highlight the element also. You can just notice here. As soon as I say hash email, this is a search box, guys. So you will get the search box if I press control F on your HTML. Place your cursor on HTML, control F, which will open the search box. Here itself, we can test whether your locator is correct or not. So hash email, email has the ID of the element. When you press enter, which is trying to highlight the HTML code along with the element. So you can also specify the tag name. So tag name is input. So still it is able to find the element. So here you can test that. So now let us try to use it here. So then David, so this is the one way we can use it, or you can also try to use like this. You can directly specify tag is input hash email. You can specify this one, or you can use this one. Either way is correct. So this is one combination. So this is tag and ID combination. Okay, first statement, let us try to execute. Run as Java application. Okay, now it is launched my page. Okay, now you can see it is enter some value in the box. So by using tag and ID, it is able to locate the element. And same thing for this also. This is also exactly the same because tag name is optional. So when I run this, so this will also able to locate the element. So you no need to write a complete program to test this, guys. So because in the Chrome itself, we have a tools like this, search is also there. And I will also show you how to use CrowPath and selector hubs. There are other plugins also available. So you can use these tools to verify your locator is properly locating your element or not before using this locator in your script. Okay. So now we can see it is added some value. So both are perfectly fine. Right. So this is how we can use tag and ID combination. So tag and ID will always separate with the hash. And if you don't want to use tag, then you can directly use hash email. Email is the ID of the element. Okay. And then we'll see how we can use tag and class combination. Tag and class combination. So tag and class combination. I'm just comment this also. So for the same element, again, I'm trying to use tag and class combination. So if I just go to the page again, I want to locate the same element by using tag and class combination. So if I see this HTML, what is the tag here? Input is my tag name. And what is the class here? Input text is a class name. You can just see. So tag and class is always separated with the dot. So dot, I'll say input text and say enter. Now we can see. So it is input dot input text, it is trying to locate two elements. See this, because class and tag name both are same for email and password. If I just keep on clicking on this, it is identifying the two elements. It is identifying the two elements, but how we can extract a specific element? So this is another important entry question, guys. So if your locator is matching with multiple elements, which element will be extracted first? Okay. So when I use this locator along with the find elements, then it will return multiple web elements. So when I use this locator with find element, then it will return the first element, and whichever comes first on the HTML, that element will be returned. So when I press enter, it is matching with the two elements, first element and second element. See this, both elements, because tag and the class both are same for both elements. But I want to capture the first element. So then what I have to do is take this locator, and here I'll say driver dot find element
by.css selector, and here keep this statement. Now what happens is, even though this locator is matching with more than one element, and here I'm using find element single, right? So it will return single web element. But among the two elements, which element will be returned? The whichever element comes first in the HTML, that element will be returned. Remember, guys. But when I use find elements method, what happens? This statement will return multiple web elements because this locator is matching with more than one element. But when I use only single find element, then even though this locator is matching with multiple web elements, the first element will be returned. That is, single element will be returned. Okay. So now class and tag and class combination, we'll separate both by using dot and dot send keys. And here I'm passing some value. I'll say John. And tag name is always optional. Without tag name also you can use. Suppose I'm removing the tag name here. I'll say dot input. Still it is able to locate the element. So either you can write this way or you can write this way. Without using tag also you can write. So if you want to use a class in CSS selector, you can use a dot, dot class value. So now I'm commenting this. So let us try to execute this. So same field, same element, but this time we are able to locate by using tag and a class combination. Right click, run as Java application. Yeah, now it is entered a value in the first element. Perfect. Okay, so now we are successfully able to locate the element by using tag and class. So you can simply use class itself without tag name also you can use. So when I pass this class dot input text, we have to pass in the CSS selector. So when I run this, which will also do the same thing. Right, so now it is entered the same value. All right, so with this, we have seen how to use ID and class along with the tags in CSS selector. And along with this, we also have tag and attribute. So here we have to specify value of ID. Here we have to specify the value of the class. But when I say tag and attribute combination, I say tag and attribute combination. That means we can specify any attribute. Okay, so here we have a choice. So here we have to use only ID attribute value. Here we have to use only class attribute value. But here, attribute in the sense, we can use any attribute of the element. Here we have a choice to use or choose specific attribute. So let's see how we can do this. I'm commenting this for the same element again. Observe this carefully. So for the same element, this is a text which is highlighted for the element. Okay, now tag and attribute. So what is the tag here? Dot input. So input is a tag. Input is a tag. So when I say input, it is matching with multiple elements. And attribute is always put in the square brackets. So what attribute we can use it here? Look at this element. The first element. So here there are multiple attributes we have. We can use either type, class, name, ID, data, test ID, placeholder. We can use any of these attributes. Anything is fine. So let me just use a class attribute here. Because we don't use tag and class here, because tag and class combination, we have a separate locator. Tag dot class name is specified. So you can also use directly here input. And in the double quotation, we have to specify class. Class equal to input text. We can use like this. So class input text, so we should not put any double quotations or single quotations. Input is my tag name and attribute class equal to input text is not working. Just a moment. Okay, sorry, we have to put like this. Input is a tag name, tag and attribute combination. So input is my tag name dot class. Here if you have to use dot. So what is the class here? So input dot class. Class is input text. So I'll say input text. Input text is my class name, tag and class. And then we have to specify the attribute. So class name is optional based. We are going to discussing this combination, tag and attribute. So tag and attribute, we can simply use tag and attribute without using class name also we can use. So I can simply say bracket, tag is input, and attribute, you can say like this, input in the bracket, name equal to, let's say email. Okay, now we can see input is my tag, input is my tag, and name equal to email is an attribute. So here input I am using as a tag, name equal to email. So here you can say name equal to email is there. So that is an attribute I'm using. So this will able to locate the first element. And similarly, you can also use some other attribute. I can simply say class, and the value of the class is input text. I think we have to pass the complete value. So here there is a space also available. So let us try to use some other. There's an ID also I can use. ID equal to, so what is the ID? Email. So which is also you can use. So now still able to find the element. And I can use one more attribute. I can say data hyphen test ID. Data hyphen test ID. So what is the value of data hyphen test ID? Royal underscore email. So royal underscore email. So this will also able to locate the element. So attribute, in the sense, in the square bracket you can choose or you can put any attribute which is available for that element. So then it will able to locate the element. And here also tag is an optional value. So tag and attribute combination, tag is always optional. You can directly specify the attribute without using tag also. So see this, which will able to locate the element. And similarly, you can just say name equal to email. So attribute you can directly specify in the bracket, which will able to locate the element. And similarly, I'll say data hyphen test ID, data hyphen test ID, and equal to royal underscore email, royal underscore email. So which will able to locate the element. So this is how we can use tag and attribute combination. Tag and attribute combination. So tag and class we separated with the dot. Tag and attribute we can separate with like this. Tag, in the bracket we have to specify attribute equal to value also. And whichever attribute you can use, you can still use it. And equal to value we have to specify. So here also tag name is optional. Okay. Now let us see how we can use tag and attribute. So here driver dot find element by dot, so by dot CSS selector, and here in the double quotation we have to specify tag and attribute. So here you can see, you can directly specify the attribute or you can say tag and attribute. So you can say, let's try to use name here. So what is the name here? Email. So you can directly use this one without tag name also you can use. I'm putting like this, and then send keys, and here I pass some value or you can say some different value. So you can directly put this or you can add tag name also. And what is a tag name? Input is a tag name. So I can say input is a tag name. So this is always optional. Tag name is always optional. So let us try to execute the first statement and run as Java application. Okay, so now it is able to locate the element and pass a value. So this is a one combination we can use in tag and attribute. So tag and attribute, without using tag name you can use, with the tag name also you can use. As I said, tag is a optional value. Run as Java application. And quotations are not required inside the attribute. Okay, so name or email, we don't need quotations. So again, it launches a web page and I can pass a value, right? So this is how we can use tag and attribute combination, right? Suppose tag and attribute combination, if I take this one, or I'll say tag is input, right? Name equal to, I'll say tag class and attribute combination also we have. So tag, okay, I'll say class, tag name dot class is input text. See this, when I use this one, okay, input text. So now you can see tag and class combination, when I use, it is matching with the two elements, okay, input tag, input dot input text, which is matching with the two elements. So to differentiate these two elements, I will add one more element. So one more attribute, which will differentiate these two elements. Okay. So how we can add is, we can just add some separate attribute in the square brackets. Okay. So here I'm just going to add something called data hyphen test ID. Observe this carefully. Data hyphen test ID equal to, the value is royal underscore email. I'll say royal underscore email. Now observe this. So this will able to match only one element, only single element. There's a email field. And suppose if I change the test ID, royal underscore pass, that is a password field. I'll say royal underscore pass. Then it is able to locate the second element. That is your password. Okay, so that's your password. So class and tag is same. Tag name and class name is same for both elements. But to separate these elements, we can just add some additional attribute which will locate the element uniquely. So I'll say royal email, then it will locate the first element. So let us try to use this. So the next one is, I'll comment this also, tag, class and attribute combination. So how we can specify driver.findElement, my.csselector, and in the double quotation, specify this. Input is my tag name, input text is my class, and this is the attribute. So which will find the first element, that is email, and then I'm passing the value called as a Smith. Okay, similarly, let us try to identify the second element. Copy the same thing. And instead of royal email, I'll say royal pass, right? So this is a royal underscore pass is a test ID attribute. So royal underscore pass, and here I'm passing some password ABC. So this is the email address and this is a password field. So in both class and attribute is same, but the class and tag name is same, but the attributes will be different. Okay. Now we can see how we can use this. So you can use any attribute, guys. So here I'm using just a data test ID, royal email, data test ID, royal password. Instead of using this, you can also use name also. So whatever attributes are available for this element, which will uniquely identify. So for example, let us take name here. So name is email here. Here a name is password. You can use a name attribute, right? So similarly, whichever the attribute is differentiate these two elements, you can use that one. So here I'm choosing data test ID is a different. So you don't put any single or double quotation inside the square brackets. So first element will identify the username field and pass this value. Second element will identify the password field and then pass a value. So here tag a class and attribute combination. Now when I run this code, which will enter username and password. Okay, so now we can see it is enter the username and also password, right? So this is how we can use a different combinations of CSS selector. So we have seen tag and ID, tag and class, tag and attribute, tag, class and attribute. So here you can say tag, the syntax is tag, class, classes, here we say class name, and here we say attribute and value. And how we can test the CSS selector before using your script, you can just open the search box and here you can test all XPath, CSS selectors, whatever locators you want to use, you can test them before using in your script. You can test them here, and then if it is properly locating the element, highlighting the element, and then you can use this in your script. Okay, so this is how we can work with the CSS selectors. So far we have seen how to use these basic locators like ID, name, link text and partial link text, class name and tag name. And along with, we also seen how to use CSS selectors with the different combinations like ID, class, attribute and class, tag, class and attributes. Okay, so in the next session, I'll show you how we can work with the XPath. So XPath is very, very important, and we have to do lot of things XPath. So we are going to discuss about what is XPath, different types of XPath, how to capture the XPath, XPath functions. So we will discuss XPath in the next session. Okay. So this is all about basic locators concept. All right. So that's all for this session. I'm stopping here.